So let's take a piece of mRNA that we're going to translate. And I want to make it very clear that we're dealing with prokaryotic mRNA. And I'm saying that because eukaryotic mRNA is actually going to be a little bit different, and we'll see later in what ways. So let's start with our 5' size. So we have this non-coding region that's in yellow, and that's just a part of the mRNA that the ribosome is not going to translate. So whatever's written there is not going to end up in our polypeptide chain. And the non-coding regions do have certain functions. We're just not going to get into it right now. And then after the non-coding region, we have the Shine-Delgarno sequence that you see here in blue. And that's actually the part on the mRNA that the ribosome recognizes and will bind to. So I'm just going to draw a little ribosome over here to help us remember that. And then we have another non-coding region, which can be a little bit larger or smaller than how I drew it. And then finally, we hit the start codon, AUG, that tells our ribosome to begin translating. And so the ribosome will read all of these codons and put together the corresponding polypeptide. And I'm actually going to circle all the codons so that we get a picture of how many amino acids are going to be in this particular polypeptide chain that we're making. And so we actually have 10 codons here. And so because we have 10 codons, this polypeptide chain will have 10 amino acids. I'm just going to abbreviate amino acids AA. And just to give you a little bit of perspective, so this is a very small polypeptide chain. Most of the polypeptide chains in our body have between 200 and 300 amino acids. Okay, so at some point, the ribosome will hit the stop codon right here in orange. And the stop codon can be one of three codons. It can be UAA, UAG, or UGA. And then we have another non-coding region. Sorry if I didn't make it clear, but the stop codon basically tells the ribosome to stop translating. And then again, the non-coding region here in yellow, which I'm just going to write NCR. So let's begin translating. The first step is initiation. And so what happens during initiation is the ribosome recognizes this Shine-Delgarno sequence and binds to the mRNA, and then it moves to the right, kind of scanning the mRNA until it hits this start codon, AUG. And you can see there are these boxes represent three basic sites on the ribosome. There's the E site, the P site, and the A site. And in just a few minutes, I'll explain why they're given those letters as names. And so the next thing that's going to happen is, so we're looking at our AUG codon here in the P site, and the corresponding tRNA molecule is going to line up with our AUG. So you can see the anticodon on this tRNA molecule is UAC, and that's complementary to AUG, and it's holding on to the amino acid. It's a little bit difficult to see, so I'm going to draw it. It's holding on to the amino acid formal methionine. And this is going to be the first amino acid in our polypeptide chain, and I want you to just keep in mind that this is in prokaryotes. In eukaryotes, it's just going to be plain methionine. And so what is formal methionine? Well, it's just the amino acid methionine, but with a formal group attached to it somewhere on the molecule. So it's a modified version of methionine. And so this actually takes care of initiation, the first step in translation. And let's move on to the next step. So initiation was our first step. And now we're going to move on to our second step, which is elongation. And in this step, we're actually going to start putting together our polypeptide. And so let's just pretend like this codon right over here is AAA. And so the corresponding tRNA molecule with the anticodon UUU is going to line up with that codon. And just in case you're wondering, how does it know to line up, or like how exactly does it happen? So really, there are a bunch of tRNA molecules floating around the ribosome, which of course I didn't draw because it would just make the picture very cluttered. And they it's actually like trial and error. The tRNAs will kind of all try to bind to this particular AAA site, and they're all just going to kind of not stick unless the anticodon is UUU. Okay, so let's go back to our process of elongation. This bond right over here between the tRNA and the formylmethionine is going to break. And if you recall, it's a very high energy or unstable bond. So when it's broken, it releases a lot of energy. And that energy is then used to drive a reaction that will create a bond between these two amino acids. And that bond is, I'm going to write it over here, a peptide bond. So a peptide bond is a bond between two amino acids. So this is a peptide bond. And now what's going to happen is the ribosome is going to shift to the right by a distance of approximately one codon. And so the tRNA that's in the P site will move to the E site. The tRNA that's in the A site will move to the P site. And so let's see what that actually looks like. So here's our next step. So before, our tRNA with UAC was in the P site, but now it moved to the E site, and it's actually going to exit. It's going to leave. So it exits. And in our P site, we have this tRNA molecule with the anticodon UUU, and it's holding on to these two amino acids, and our A site is empty. And let's just say that the codon here in our A site is CCC. And I didn't draw these compartments in a very exact way because on the ribosome, they're also not an exact way, but it's just to give you a picture. So the tRNA molecule with the anticodon that's complementary to CCC is going to come and line up with the codon just like that. And again, we're going to break the bond between this tRNA and the amino acid that it's attached to. And the energy from that bond being broken will drive a different reaction that will make this peptide bond between those two amino acids. And again, the ribosome will now shift to the right by a distance of about one codon. And let's see what this looks like. So we're still in the middle of elongation. And so the tRNA that was in the P site moved to the E site, the tRNA that was in the A site moved to the P site, and now our A site is empty. I want to just pause for a second to help and describe why these sites are given these names. And so the E site stands for exit site because the tRNA molecule exits from that site. So it's the exit site. The P site is named the P site because it stands for the peptidyl tRNA site. And so this tRNA that sits in the P site is the peptidyl tRNA because it's a tRNA that's holding on to the growing polypeptide chain. And the A site is called the A site because it stands for the amino acyl tRNA site. Actually, maybe I should have drawn it closer to the actual site. So that's our A site, stands for amino acyl tRNA site. P stands for peptidyl tRNA site. And going back to our amino acyl tRNA site, so an amino acyl tRNA is simply a tRNA molecule that's holding on to the amino acid that it's supposed to hold on to. And so we call this the amino acyl tRNA site because that's where the amino acyl tRNAs first come. So let's take our amino acyl tRNA and let's put it into the site that it belongs. And if the anticodon is AAA, then that tells us that the mRNA codon just beneath it is going to be UUU. And again, the bond between this tRNA molecule and the amino acid is going to break. And a new bond will form between this amino acid and the phenylalanine. And so hopefully you're getting the picture. And once this happens, the ribosome again moves to the right, And we're not going to go through all the codons, but it's basically going to read all of this. And let's fast forward until it hits the stop codon, which leads us to the last step in translation. And so the last step in translation is termination. And this happens when the stop codon enters the A site. You can see it again right over here. And that tells the ribosome to stop translating. And so the two subunits will separate. The mRNA will be degraded or broken down, and the parts will be recycled. And we've actually achieved our goal. We made a polypeptide, a chain of amino acids.